Hello everyone, this is Brian, and I'm going to show you problem number 8 in chapter 2, ticks, tip, tax, and total. This program, design a program that calculates the total amount of a meal purchased at the restaurant. The program should ask the user to enter the charge for the food and then calculate the amount of a 15% tip and 7% sales tax. Display each of these amounts and the total. So first of all, let's take a look at this here. We're going to have two different constants. Now, I just looked at this here, and I said that basically the tip rate and the tax rate are not going to change. Let's assume in our program here that they'll be constant, and we're going to assume those are constants there. Okay. So now, of course, let's take a look at, in most of our programs here, we want to go with this theme here of inputs, process, and outputs. So first of all, let's take a look at inputs. So when we look at our program definition here, or our problem statement here, we're going to assume that we have the bill amount as an input here. And the outputs are these three different outputs. They're going to be the tax amount, the tip amount, and the total. And of course, the process to get these three different outputs based upon our input here. So when we look at this here, we have that the tax amount is based upon a calculation of the tax rate times the bill amount, and then the tip amount here is going to be the tip rate times the bill amount. So that gives us that. And then of course, to calculate the total, we're going to add the initial bill amount, which is the bill amount variable here, which we said is the input, tip amount that we calculated, tax amount that we calculated, and we're going to calculate this third total value. So basically that shows the process we're going to go through. So let's go ahead and write our program here. We have all our pieces here to create our program. So first of all, I'm going to add in some constants here, and comments and the constants. So you can see right here, I just emphasize that this is the beginning of the program here. And here's my comments here. So declare the constants here. Same thing I did said above, but now you'll notice that I added in that this is a type constant here and a real, and then here's the 0.07 that represents a tip or tax rate, and the other one here is the tip rate. It's also a real constant. Now let's take a look at our variables. Okay, so our variables are going to be one variable for input and one variable for output. So we look at this here. Both of them are going to be real because we know that money can have fractional amounts. So we're going to have the bill amount, that's initial on the bill, and then after we calculate that, when we looked at our total, our process above, we calculated total. Now we're going to put in the inputs, or put in some code here, our pseudo code, to gather the input from the user. So we're going to display enter in the bill amount, and then the input here and the bill amount variable. Now we're going to do our process. It looks almost exactly the same that we defined when we focused on what the process is. Take the constant tax rate times the bill amount here, set it to the tax amount, same thing for tip amount, and then of course we add the three different things to get the total here. That completes our process, and now we have the variables, or the outputs, all the variables for the tax amount, tip amount, total, and of course we have our initial bill amount. So we're going to display this all to the user after we've calculated this. Now I've added in the bill amount on the output here. So you can see I added in a statement here. It says the amount before tax and tip is bill amount. And then of course I say here the tip amount is the calculated tip amount, which is the tip amount variable. And then I display the tax with a statement saying the tax amount is tax amount, and then the grand total is our variable for total. And that ends our program for problem number 8. Thank you.